Hi guys, today it's going to be something very, very interesting that I will be doing. It's been quite the time. It's been almost like 13, 14 years since I entered into an engineering classroom. This approach by Bridge Labs is something that I'm totally in and excited about because it's a practical experience. I really did wish when I was doing engineering that there was an opportunity for this to have happened side by side because I would have got the concept a lot better. Coding might have been a lot more fun rather than trying to be rudimentary and, you know, trying to get those things done, get the exams out of the way. It would have been a lot better. Yes, I did take up classes by the side with all your, you know, other platforms that were made available to us. But this sort of a practical experience was a very far cry. I'd like to go into the classroom and see exactly how this is happening and also surprise some people. Let's go.
Is my screen visible? Say yes or no.
Yes, sir.
So we'll have the ML introduction. We'll understand what machine learning is. Now, what we want to do, we would like to predict the emission of a future car based on the engine size. Okay. So first step, in your Google Colab, in this cell, I'll be sharing the code and I'll be giving you an understanding of the code, and then you should code this. So for any machine learning Python program, so there are different libraries, different dependencies which we have to include in our code. Now, following dependencies we will be including in our code. Now we are going to get some data and use this data to do our prediction. So you should import a data. I am doing the scatter plot using this data frame which I have created, keeping the x-axis as engine level, y as the CO2 emission. I'll share this code and execute that. And if you have any query, please do ask me. Any place where you're getting stuck, you can inquire. Now I'm going to create the model. So I have divided the data. Now, if you see the sklearn we had imported from the sklearn, I'm asking it to do the linear regression using this data. So I am going to execute that. Given this model, let's see for a future car which we are designing, what will be my CO2 emission. Now my future engine size is 3.5. Given the 3.5, I'd like to predict using this model what will be my estimated emission. And I'm going to execute this. It gives me estimated emission of 262.95. So this is the way a regression model works. I hope all of you have understood. Any questions, any clarifications you can ask right now.
I have a question.
Who is this? Can you make your video on and share your question?
Hi.
Hey!
Hello!
Hey!
Hi, sir. What a surprise!
I've been through several engineering classes myself before I've finished passing out, but this is something very new. I've heard a lot about Bridge Labs, so I thought I'll just come in and check how you guys are going.
Great. Good to have you here, Ashwin, and part of the learning experience. So glad. So how was your experience, Ashwin, in this regard to the class? How do you see that? Have you understood? How was your experience in the learning?
Look, I think it was when I did my engineering, right? It was very different, and there was no concept of getting someone job ready, and constantly it was all about getting to the syllabus, getting to the whatever they gave, and buying your books and studying on your own, getting through classes. Basically, even getting your records in, sorting out your practical classes and all that. But it was all about doing what you were asked to do, rather than trying to understand what exactly you had to do and how to equip yourself to be job ready. But to exactly get the algorithm right or exactly have an understanding of these platforms were, you know, very, very different. So that's one thing I really love about BigTab, how they are trying to equip you and make you job ready before you actually.
Absolutely, you are true, Vashin. You just cannot learn cricket by reading a book. You'll have to go to the field, you'll have to practice, you'll have to do the daily net practice, then only you get to know. And that's the philosophy we also apply. And we do it through the learn. Our philosophy is learn by doing. We have a concept of a maker plan. So we use that, and using that, everyone does. And it's through the practice one learns. So Ashwin, I know that one of your incident in during your initial days, you had to choose between the club, playing for a club which is going to pay you a very handsome money, versus a smaller club where you need to practice more and more and improve yourself. Can you share how important it is for you to prioritize on this developing the skills during the initial framing time, initial part of the career?
But this is a very interesting question. A lot of people haven't asked me this question in my life. Yes, I have noted it down and mentioned it to a few people. But I think it's very pertinent, because one of the reasons why I still hold on to my decisions, I still do what I believe is right, is because it started giving me results very early in my life. So I put across the pros and cons, and so I went up to my the mentor, who is quite the don, and I told him, look, A, B, C are the reasons why I would want to play for the other team, and I don't see any of those reasons that will enable me when I play for your team. And this is nothing personal, it is purely professional from my side. For which he actually told me, you know, tomorrow if there are selections and you don't get selected, you shouldn't come crying. I said, if I don't put runs on the board, if I don't put wickets on the board, nobody can help me. At the end of the day, this is my life. I have chosen to play the game for the last 10 years. I completely respect you for what you have given me, and I will continue to respect you for whatever you will or maybe you will not give me in life in the future. But this is the decision I am making. Come what may, I will live and die by my decision. And that's the motto of my life. And thankfully, it worked well. And I'm sure 9 out of 10 times it will work.
So with that belief, how do you see this setup through which we are grooming? So we are mentoring through the senior engineers. How do you see the setup in the Bridge Lab?
It is direct, right? I don't know if people are able to connect the dots already. When you said senior engineer, you are talking about people who have gone through the hard grind, who are here to upscale themselves and be equipped for what's coming in front of them. So I think that is a direct relation. If this Bridge Lab is going to be a practical experience and you are allowed to make mistakes and master your skills, which is exactly how life. We are all going to make mistakes, learn from it, and master and paper the cracks over it. So, if that is an opportunity this is providing, then this is a direct pathway to excellence. So, I don't see a massive break in it.
I see. Okay, good. So, Ashwin, also I'd like to share that wish you best for the upcoming season. Wish you all the best, and on behalf of Bridge Lab, all the very best to you.
Thank you so much. So, guys, that was me getting into a class, revisiting my engineering days, and also having a wonderful time. I did have a wonderful time, and also got the ability to surprise and put a little bit of a googly to the staff who's teaching them. And now it's up to you guys. Keep working hard and keep going through the yards, and who knows, I could surprise you the next time around. And I'm sure to surprise you. Keep working hard, and you may be the next lucky one to get to meet.